Hello, welcome. How's it going, everybody? We're back. Happy Wednesday. I'm super excited to be here. We got some good game. I can't wait. We're gonna do some caveman gaming. Welcome in. I'm so excited. I love caveman. I love game. What could go better than caveman gaming? Welcome. Welcome, 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 welcome. Let me say hello. Gotta say hello. Gotta say hello. Hello. Dana Chrysalis. Hello. Alonore the Gaming Cat. Hello. Dark Rolft. Hello. Duck Admirer. Hello. G12345. Hello. Head Wound Yoda. Hello. Kaius. Thank you for the Bart Pig. Hello. Foamed. Degenesis Fied. Welcome. Dracados. SGBU. Sam Hind. Beautiful Skeletons. Thank you. Don't fluff the pillows. Hello. Neck. Welcome. Hotzen, welcome. Atelier Zeno, welcome. Tralala Radio Network, welcome. Damien Fox, welcome. Samson, welcome everybody. How's it going? No more Simpsons. Sorry to say it. For now, for the moment, for the time being, we must move away from Simpsons games. Let me fix the camera. Every day, every day. Nope. We're gonna move away from Simpsons games for a little bit at least. There's always more Simpsons games to come back to. The well will never run dry. We'll come back in time for more Simpsons gaming. But today, we're gonna play Prehistorik on the Amiga. I'm really excited for this. Look at that beautiful red fox down in the bottom right. Oh, baby, that's a good sign. This is a quality French developed by Titus Amiga platformer. I'm excited. This is a genre of game I've been really wanting to dive into and really sink my teeth in, Amiga platformers specifically. So, I've played a couple in the past. I'm not too well versed in the land of Amiga platformers. I'm really excited to play Prehistoric. This is gonna be fun. N39, welcome. Oh, you had this, Dracados? Sweet. Yeah, you get to walk around and bash people with your club. It's so good. It's so good. As far as I can tell, this game. Now, this is kind of a guess on my part. This is speculation, conjecture. I think this game was initially developed on the Amstrad CPC. And then it got ported from the Amstrad CPC to other platforms like the Amiga, DOS, Atari ST. I want to say there's a couple more as well. We're gonna be playing the Amiga version simply for the better graphics and audio. I probably should have, in retrospect, played the Amstrad version just for the authentic original experience. We're gonna play the Amiga version. Maybe we'll check out the Amstrad one later. Yeah, this is the first in a series of games. Titus made a number of prehistoric games. There's Prehistoric 1, Prehistoric 2 as well. Prehistoric 2 was on the Amstrad and DOS, I believe. It might have an Amiga port. And then there's Prehistoric Man on the Super Nintendo. And then there's Prehistoric Man on the Game Boy. And then there's like Prehistoric Man 2. There's like, I think, five of them. Yeah, Prehistoric Man on the Super Nintendo. Funny enough, Prehistoric Man is on Nintendo Switch Online service because they have the most baffling choice of games on there. So I've played that one before. I've played Prehistoric Man on Super Nintendo on the Switch. And that game's really fun. That was a number of years back. I can't wait to play this one though. This looks so good. This looks so good. The boss battles are silly. I'm very excited. Not much to talk about with the box art here. Get Stone Age tablet with goofy word art and some cave drawings. You get a caveman with a club trying to bash a dino. You get Titus Fox. Good. If we flip that box over. Oh. Half human, half hungry. Prehistoric. Raider of the Lost Nosh. Prehistorik, a member of the T-Bone tribe, is hungry and ready for a bronco lunch. Armed with Diner Club, his faithful Frazzler, he sets off on his food-spotting expedition. Follow Prehistorik from the unexplored ice fields of Antarctica, the darkened, mysterious caverns of the shady continent, to the lush jungles of the tropics. Featuring Rhinodendron, King Congerous 12, Chimpagogo, Boa de Sauce, Pyrotax, and many other chops. Lunch is served. I don't know what I just read. Dude, that's what got me so hyped, Nick. Dana, yes, yes, that bottom left screenshot. It's wonderful. A screen-sized buff caveman boss fight. I can't wait. I can't wait to bash him with my club. There's over 150 screens of gameplay in this. This is a flick screen platformer. It's not like a side scroller. It doesn't have continuous scrolling, smooth scrolling, anything like that. It's screen by screen. Flick screen is what they call it. So they have over 150 screens of gameplay. And because it's not like a true side scroller, it's kind of why I suspect this game was initially conceived and developed for a lower spec of computer, specifically the Amstrad CPC, and then got ported from there to different platforms. But that's just, again, conjecture on my part. Yeah, the screenshots look wonderful, though. Bright, colorful graphics. You got an ice stage. You got a caveman stage. You got a tree stage. And you got a big buff caveman with a screen-sized sprite. Oh, dude. Look at that picture in the bottom right, too. I wonder if that's like a cave or a Titus employee posing as a caveman. What a lucky fella. Dude, this looks incredible. This looks incredible. Yeah, step back, barbarian gaming. We got caveman gaming here. There's quite a bit of similarities between barbarian gaming and caveman gaming. You must admit. There's probably, on the whole, more barbarian games than there are caveman games. But who's counting? Oh, the CD TV. There's a couple Amiga CD TV games I'd like to play. I still want to check out that Whale's Voyage version on the Amiga CD. It'd be a disaster. It'd be a good disaster. Let's read the manual. We got to dive in. We got 150 screens to get to. We got a lot of caveman gaming to do. So let's read the manual. Bing. Cute little booklet here. My windows are getting all messed up here. Oh, look at the artwork. Prehistorik, our ancestor. Hey, Monty Avocado, welcome. Caveman Uglympics. I played the NES version of Caveman Uglympics. I used to have it as a kid. Many, many, many long years ago. I loved it. Everyone else in my family, my friends, hated it. Never got a chance to play it that much. The NES version's called just simply Caveman Games. I thought that was a wonderful game. Granted, this is 30-year-old memories talking, so maybe it's really bad. But I used to play that as a kid. Prehistorik, our ancestor. As in all the great tribes, storytelling was an important tradition in my family. At night, around the campfire, Grandpa would tell us the hair-raising adventures of our ancestors. Since our family is famous for its extraordinary memory, some of these stories could go back very far in time. And so it is with the story you're now going to live. It takes place in the oldest time of all prehistoric time. Back then, early man had a very different lifestyle to ours. If you wanted to stay alive, you had to eat. Since they spent most of their time searching for food, some early men, like Prehistorik, became experts at hunting with clubs. This is the time you're now going to relive along with Prehistorik, the most daring member of my great family. The Saga of the Zoglors. Almatia, welcome. Dialoco, welcome. Oh, nice, you played this. I've never played this before. I played Prehistoric Man on the Super Nintendo, but I've never played any of the other games. The Zog, the Zoglords. The Zoglords were in a bad way. No food and no drink for 3 days. No dino burgers, no sorrow soups, just bones and beaks. Bad black days. The tribe was very upset. The Zogettes had cried themselves wet. The Zogeyes were fighting when quickly as lightning, Prehistoric jumped up like a jet. They have a limerick? I've just seen the light, he said, while lying here hungry in bed. We must use our clubs, we must use our heads, and then he went off to the hunt. And the moral of the story is, if you want to eat, you've got to hunt. Okay, that's the moral. The control panel. You have to collect food to score points. Every edible thing that you meet in the game equals a certain number of points, which are added to your total. If you want to score, you have to eat. At the end of each level, bonus points are added to your score. You got timer. Start with time units. I love it when they refer to it as simply time units, because that's how you know the timer is either really fast or really slow. It's not 1 second, one unit. If you don't finish the level in time, you lose a life, but can continue the level with additional units. I love me some units of time. Oh, there's our little guy. There he is. Your food meter starts off at zero. You must fill up your food supply as much as possible before you finish the level. So pick up everything you can get your hands on. If you're unlucky or lazy, and you reach the end of the level without filling up your supply, you'll see this message. Not enough food. This means you must go back and pick up some more groceries. So yeah, each level is kind of like a collectathon. You gotta go around and bash enemies and get food, and you have to collect all the food in the stage to move on to the next one. Just not just simply get to the end of the stage, but you gotta get food as well. I start with 3 lives. Every time you fall in a hole or your energy level falls to zero, you lose a life. At the end of every level, you win an extra life. Hint, look closely. There are bonus lives hidden everywhere. Energy, when you're touched by an enemy or if you touch an obstacle, your energy level's decreased. When your energy level reaches zero, you die. You lose a life, sorry. Amiga joystick control, so one button. Joystick, go left, right, climb with up, enter into caves by pressing down, up to jump, jump over peaks and fires. Oh, what's the deep lore here? Olivier Diaz appears to be the main guy behind Prehistoric. His only other credits are game design on Rayman 2 and We are most grateful to those who accompanied us for a time special thanks to Beyond Good and Evil. That's kind of bizarre. Fighting. In this dangerous prehistoric world, you have to know how to use your club to defend yourself from enemy attacks. One less enemy means one more piece of food in your supplies. Technique is simple and effective. When a troublemaker sticks his nose in too close, you just press the fire button to immediately let loose his club, Anticus. But remember, some monsters are stronger than others. Further on in this manual, you'll find a list of the different enemies and the number of clubbings needed to knock them out. Yes, dude. Look at the dino. Look at, dude, the graphics are so cute. Look at the little fire-breathing furball. Look at this, dude. This is wonderful. Once you've knocked out your enemy, you'll see stars over his head. You just walk on top of him to add him to your food supply. But if you're not quick about it, an arrow will start flashing. This means that he'll soon be back on his feet and ready to fight. If you touch a peak, a fire, or a rock, which you can destroy by hitting with your club, or when you're touched by an enemy, your energy level decreases, a flashing halo will surround you for a few seconds. making you totally invincible, so you can take your revenge. Look at this. This is a civilized Amiga game that doesn't have generation damage. That's actually really impressive. Oh, you went on to do Android and iPhone games, but they aren't on Mobi games. There's a lot of stuff not on Mobi games, surprisingly, but it's all about user input and submissions to fill out their database. In the caves. Dude, look at the pixel art. This is incredible. I mean, there's obviously, like, repetition of patterns. So it's not, like, a completely unique scene, but it looks incredible. I really like this style of graphics. It's like a cartoon turkey, a human-sized pear, a clock that's as big as the caveman. I hope we get to bash the clock. You'll find the most food in the caves. Beware, they're often well-guarded. The bats aren't too much of a problem. One smash the club and they're done for. The spiders are indestructible. One bite means one less energy point. They used to be arachnophobic. Kind of weird that you can bash dinosaurs and 90 feet tall, muscular cavemen, but a little spider. Too strong. Don't question it, though. Watch out for fires. If you get burnt, you lose a point. To leave the cave, you have to move to the left. In some caves, a sign on the right side of the cave will show you another exit by a different cave. If you take this dangerous route, you'll have some protection. When you leave the cave, you'll be covered by your flashing halo for a few seconds. Enough time to see if there's any enemies around. Important. Not all the food is found in the caves. You can also find it in the secret rooms. Or even by knocking in the void in certain precise locations. What in the world does... I guess that just means there's secrets? What? Knock? Okay. The caves aren't just for picking up food. You can also find bonuses, which will come in handy later on in the game. Yo, Mix Champion, welcome. For now. We played like 8 Simpsons games in a row. For now, I've had my fill of Simpsons gaming. We'll come back to it with time. There's always more Simpsons games on the horizon. The bonuses give you an extra edge. Get the alarm, adds 30 time units to the time meter. The bomb knocks out all enemies on the screen. The shield makes you invincible. The axe lets you knock out your enemies with one blow. The spring lets you jump higher and further. The cross of life gives you an extra life. I like the little arrow. Turn the page, please. Okay. There are two ways to pick up a bonus, in the caves or through the guru meditation. I got some memes here in this game, I see. The guru meditation. He appears in different places in the game. Even though he looks like he's sleeping, he's always carrying a bonus. As soon as you see him appear, run up to him and hit him over the head with a club. Just to wake him up, of course. He's not nasty, and when he disappears, he'll leave you a bonus. A pile of junk mail, welcome. We'll see. I might play Prehistorik 2. It depends on if I like this one enough. I mean, I've played Prehistorik Man on the Super Nintendo, and I enjoyed that game. If I enjoy this one too, we'll probably play through Prehistorik 2 as well. Play that night game on the Amiga. Dude, there's so many Amiga games. I'll have to narrow it down a little bit more. He's not nasty. You just gotta bop him a little bit to wake him up. The accessories. In the course of the game, you'll meet some things which you should use to pursue your quest. Trampolines to do long jumps. Okay. Balloons in the Alpha Plane. These are more rare. To use them, climb on and use the joystick to direct your flight. Ooh. Your enemies. Gubba Glub. Dude, look at these enemies. These are just so charming, these designs. Look at the little bears. The monkey. The bird. Dude. Gubba Glub, the stupidest of them all. He usually just hangs around, but he can be dangerous if he jumps out of a cave by surprise. Two blows are necessary to do him in. Balor and Bobor. Not much different between these two cousins. Sometimes they come out of caves to hunt men. Three blows. You'll have your fill of bear meat. Pyrotax. Watch your back. Pyrocritter. A fat ball of yellow hair. Spits fire if you have the bad luck to be in his way. He's very dangerous, and it's better to avoid him. But if you can't, a single blow will turn him into a ready-to-eat Pac-Man. Hey, raccoon, welcome. Oh, nice, you played this. Yeah, I've never played this before. I'm really excited for it. Sortie jumps out of the water to poke holes in everything he finds. Even prehistoric can get skewered by this fish. Unbeatable. Chimpagogo. He lives in a palm tree, and from the top of his tree, he throws coconuts down on you. One blow's enough to get him down from his tree. Turtosaurus. I don't think that's a real dinosaur. Turtosaurus. This giant turtle. Oh, it's a giant turtle. Has been looking for her shell for many years. She's got a bad attitude and doesn't back off easily. To get rid of her, takes five blows. Finally, teriyaki. This bad luck bird doesn't go away. What's more, he has an identity problem and thinks he's a kamikaze pilot. He heads straight for you and won't be discouraged by your trusty club Anticus. Trouble. Oh, there's more. Arachna the spider. This spider likes to live in caves. She just climbs up and down her web all day long. But beware. This doesn't make her any less of a dreaded enemy. Tread carefully. Squirrel. Her favorite pastime is to bombard you with nuts. Since prehistoric nuts are pretty big, you're better off avoiding them. I couldn't get through without laughing. I tried. Don't get too close to him, he's invulnerable. Finally, Boa de Sauce, the snake who invented evil. You won't hear him coming up behind you until he suddenly springs and bites you. He's invincible. Dude, Moose and Squirrel. I want to play Rocky and Bullwinkle. Those games look so fun. And that's the manual. That's it. A wonderful time, it looks like. A truly whimsical caveman adventure. I cannot wait. I'm so excited. Let's play. This looks like it's going to be a lot of fun. Game Prehistoric Amiga 1991. Where's the capture? Game? 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 Boot up the old Amiga here. Win UAE. I love reading the manuals. I really enjoy it too. I get a kick out of it. Oftentimes, well, sometimes there's not really much of substance there, but most times I've found the manuals kind of really help get you in the mood for the game. Kind of get a sneak preview at certain things. There's often unintuitive mechanics secreted away into the text of the manual, especially when it comes to older games. I think it's worth it. I had to stop using my head torch. It made me light-headed. Welcome, Baines, and thank you. Thank you. Dude, look at this artwork. This is tremendous. This is like top tier pixel art. Prehistoric. As far as I know, we get both music and sound effects. There's no option. The manual didn't explain how to toggle between one or the other. I think we just get it all. Prehistoric finds himself empty-handed when attacked by hunger. Gifted with intelligence. He sets off in search of Nosh. Designed by Cy Bell. Coding by Diaz Olivier. Graphics by Alessandri Jean Christophe. Musics and sounds by Christophe. I can't pronounce French, I'm sorry, I don't know the proper technique. Conversion on Amiga and IBM by Movie. See, this is what makes me think, and I'm pretty sure this was originally an Amstrad CPC game. They specifically credit somebody for the port to the Amiga and DOS, IBM. Ba 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 ba. Ba 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 ba. Alright, it's just looping. Let's start the timer. Let's get some food. Let's start bashing some heads. It's loading. Please wait. I played Chuck Rock long time ago, Monte Avocado. Long time ago. It's been many, many, many moons since I last played Chuck Rock. I'd love to replay it. I never played Chuck Rock 2, Son of Chuck. One of these days, there's so many cool caveman games. Caveman games is like a vast genre full of marvelous specimens of gaming. A lot of them are kind of action games. So here we go. Level one. There's our man.
Yes!
So we can't waste time because we have a timer going. Okay, this is our spike. So we have up to jump. Using the powers of joy to key, I have decided to bind up to a button. So I'm cheating. I got hit! So yeah, you gotta bash the caveman, or bash the dinos, and then when they're bashed, you can pick them up and it fills up the food meter up there in the top. Ooh, banana. Oh! Oh, I'm getting owned. Gotta check out the caves. Ooh! Dude! Okay. Oh, dude! This is hard. I'm already almost dead. I'm halfway down. Cave? Or egg? Ooh. Guru! We got the spring! Okay, the manual said we could bash these. Good. No. Oh my goodness, I'm almost dead. Oh, the humans. I really want to play the humans. It looks like it's super fun. I almost played the humans today instead of this. Okay. What the? Cherry? Pear? Interesting. Some strange things are afoot here. So you can enter caves, and if there's a sign on the other side of the cave, that means there's an additional exit out that direction. Exiting through this direction of the sign gives you invulnerability frames when you emerge from the cave, and it sets you out at a different point. But re-entering this takes you to a different cave. Okay, so every door has a unique destination. And it's not consistent one-to-one exit and enter. I see. Jump. Bash.
Dude, this is so cool.
Bats. Get him. I wonder if you can heal. Nothing's giving me energy. Ooh, eggs. We gotta get in that door down there. Those spikes will hurt me. I think I can sneak in from over here. Whoa!
Skeletonized angel.
Got him. Oh, dude, I lost my spring. Oh no. Alright, that's fine. Dude, this game is so cool! The manual said we get secrets for knocking into the void. Whatever the heck that means. So maybe there's like pits we're supposed to jump into. Fish!
Oh, Dino, welcome. How's it going?
Bear! Is this the best game ever made? This might be. I can go back in here. Ice cream! We got some prehistoric ice cream. Bears! So again,
I got the axe! Nice.
So we can't leave the stage until I get all the food. And the bats give me food, so we gotta wait for this guy to descend, I guess? Hello? I give up. He gets to live. What is this? Monkey business? Okay, since I have the axe, I should be able to kill the turtle in one hit. This is dicey. Dude! He just owned me! What the?
This is hard!
Oh, shield. Invincibility.
Guru!
Oh, thank goodness. Okay, we got an extra life. Everything's fine. Okay. Lost the extra life. Everything's less fine.
What is this gauntlet?
Oh, run!
Da 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 da.
This is the best game ever made. Why does nobody ever talk about this in best games of all time lists?
Look at the graphics! Look at the fish! Look at his face! Look at the clouds!
Oh, okay. The egg. I still have a little bit more food to go. Time's getting real low. Got him. Go! Get him! Oh, get him! Ooh, gotta get the Ankh. Basically baby Bart, yeah. It's funny how that works, isn't it, Dana? Funny how that works. I think it is good to enjoy games. That's just my opinion.
Dude, the time!
Get down here.
Dude! Okay.
I got a couple more seconds, or sorry, time units back after I died. That's good.
Guru!
Oh, I missed out on the guru. It's so hard to avoid damage in this. We could just book it to the end of the stage. That might be smart, yeah.
But the score, the food, the satisfaction of big number, the Oonga Boonga. Ah!
Okay, man cannot swim. He's invented fire, but not swimming. This platforming looks jacked. Let's reset the screen. What the heck is this, dude? What is this? Gotta go. Gotta go. Gotta go. Oh, okay. 8-bit tomato, welcome.
Get the egg.
Da na 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 da da. Okay, nothing in here I need.
Dude!
I can't go in this cave. Oh, we might need to kill all the dinosaurs that spawn from it first. Yeah, okay, I see. So you can't enter caves until you've cleared out all the spawns that can come from it.
Oh, guru!
Dude, I'm gonna die again.
I missed it. 2 seconds. This is... We gotta go. What is this timer?
Okay, we got 50 seconds back. I don't know if I can make this jump. We gotta try it. I don't know what you're on about, Mix Champion. Omega Games, by and large, look incredible, in my opinion. Yeah, I don't think you can get everything. Okay, the timer's really strict. Okay, we're learning. You know, I've never played this before. Gotta figure this out as we go. Please wait. Please wait. Dead. That was the greatest 5 seconds of my life. That was tremendous. I couldn't even take it in. I just got overcome with excitement and started bashing the toes. That was so cool. A screen-sized dinosaur that just sits there and looks at you and you bash his toes. Dude, this is the best game ever made. Please wait. Next time we come to a boss, I'm going to try and actually take it in and actually observe what's happening in the background and the artwork instead of just going hog wild and bashing. Oh, Ice Stage. Ooh. What's that shell? Penguin! Penguin! Oh, we got different cave artwork for the ice stage? It's wonderful, isn't it? Ale durian. An ice stage with no ice physics. It's quite fantastic. I fell into the pit. What is this? Oh, those are like the eggs. Okay. Hey, walrus!
Guru!
It's really hard to get those gurus. Because you have to really, like, either get super lucky or just know where they're gonna spawn in. I'm doing terrible at avoiding damage. It's very possible.
What is that? Light? Is that French for something?
I don't know what that means. Is that milk? Oh, milk, okay.
Bash the bats!
I'm getting hit by literally everything. So we're probably going to run out of lives and be forced to restart, but honestly, that would be perfectly fine with me because this is a wonderful game. Got me. A lot of gotchas in this. Game design that some might consider unreasonable, where you enter a screen and immediately are taking damage. Me? I don't care. I think it's fine.
Bum, 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 bum. Dude,
Okay, we need to be careful not to stun the enemies on top of cave entrances. Because as soon as you pick up the corpse, a new enemy can potentially spawn. So that's one reason I'm taking so much damage, is just improper collection of enemy. We got our spring back, perfect. Dun, 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 dun. Dude, this music's going so hard. Oh no, nonsense! Okay. Go. Let's wait for the next cycle. Woo! Okay. Get up! Yes! Dude, I love to club some walruses. Wall rye? Okay. Last life. Try and play it safe now. Even something as simple as jumping over little fires is not as easy as it looks. Uh-oh. Dude! That's exactly- Guru! What? Ah, he got me. He got away. Burger? Caveman burger? I'll take it. Bum bum bum. The massive attrition damage. We're gonna get a game over here. Oh, bird! What the heck? What the? That's the Alpha Glider, or whatever it was called. Okay, this is a dangerous situation. Fire-breathing ball is gonna breathe me! Okay. Alright, we're back. What's up, Mars? Welcome. No more Bart for now. You played 8 Simpsons games in a row. It's time to mix it up a little bit. Okay, this game might be a little hard. Oh, dude! It's very difficult to avoid getting hit by everything. Oh, martini. Oh, what the? What? How? How? What? Okay. Bum 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 bum. Game over. Alright, first attempt went pretty well, I'd say. I think it went pretty well. Cool. If there were more itchy and scratchy games, maybe I prefer those, but there's so many Simpsons games, I'll just stick to those. Alright, no continues, 3 lives. Let's go again. Oh, Red and Stimpy. Yeah, same thing, basically. Definitely Simpsons, then. If I had to choose between Ren and Stimpy Gaming or Simpsons Gaming, I'd go with Simpsons Gaming. I kind of wish there were more Ren and Stimpy games, because they were so bizarre. Just the style of the Ren and Stimpy games were so cool. It's just a shame that a lot of them weren't that great. Some of them were. Well, maybe great's a little too strong. Some of them were fun. A lot of them were fun. Alright, back to the start. Let's go. So we've learned quite a bit with that first attempt. We've learned that there's way more food items than you need in the stage. We've learned to be careful about where we position enemies so we don't get owned. I say as I get owned. I'm already halfway dead. Okay. Get the pear. Guru! Okay, the guru gives you a random item, because last time that guy gave me a spring. Disaster. This is fine. We can recover. Oh, I gotta go back in there. Hey, Iron Zoltan, welcome. Lonely Demon, welcome. I used to play Caveman games when I was a kid. I had a copy of it on the NES. I thought it was super cool. Nobody else I knew liked it, so I could never play it that often, because it's mostly two-player. Oh, interesting. The enemies preserve their hit points, even when we leave the screen and come back. Hey, doo-doo, Flatulato. We did play the Game Boy games, yeah. They were quite good. Go! It's very difficult to avoid getting hit. Go back in. Oh, ice cream. I love the caveman ice cream. Hey, Furukun, Son Goku, welcome. Oh, yes! Ah, the bats. Okay. Alright, we got the hammer. We need to preserve this hammer. This hammer is vital. I got it! Okay. Careful, focus. Monkey, let's go for the monkey first. Okay, ah, he got me still.
This guy.
I don't know how to deal with a lot of these enemies. Guru. He just flashbanged nothing. Alright, thanks, Guru. He's trying his best, I suppose.
What is this? Go! Go!
Nope. Is that gonna hit me? No. I feel like I'm missing a ton of secrets. The manual said there were hidden lives everywhere. And secrets to be found by knocking into the void? Whatever the heck that's supposed to mean. I'm a little bit hesitant to, like, try experimenting jumping into pits or things like that.
Get him!
Okay. Oh, the... No! My hammer! Get an extra life here, perfect. Okay, food is full. Let's just try and hoof it to the end now.
Guru!
Ooh, thank you, Guru. Oh dear. Okay. I think I got a little lucky there. I'm gonna peek into the caves just to see if there's like an extra life in them.
Danger. Guru!
Missed him. Okay, got some clock. That's very good.
That was a backwards warp. Interesting.
I have a lot of time, but I don't want to die again. Okay, that's the exit right there. Let's just go for it.
Big jump!
Swinging at nothing, random invisible spots. That's probably correct, yeah. Here he comes. Here it comes again. Okay, we can actually try and take this in. Enjoy. Oh, dude. Oh, dude, the loading just builds the anticipation. I can't wait. I wonder if I keep my hammer with me. Maybe it'll deal more damage to him. Not that he was hard or anything. I literally just mashed the button and killed him last time. Oh, Gym Power. I've never played the Gym Power games. There's so many cool games I gotta play. Just so... Rocky Balboa music? Does he do anything? This is incredible. It's just a giant static sprite that blinks. There's no timer. Oh, careful! He killed me. Alright, he's dead. Just look at the scene on the screen right now. Look at this image. This is the power and the quality of the Amiga right here. Oh, Joe and Mac. Joe and Mac's wonderful. Joe and Mac on Super Nintendo, the first one. I distinctly remember being one of the very first games I ever beat as a kid. I remember renting Joe and Mac. I was just a young child and being overjoyed because I was actually able to finish it. So it's like literally a baby game, but it's great. I never played Joe and Mac 2. I never played Congo's Caper. There's just so many games. Just so many games. JD Amato, welcome. Please wait. Alright, back to the ice stage. So this says, the sign says level 5 to the right. But this is level 3 that we're currently on? So, I don't know. I'm just kind of ignoring the sign. I knocked into the void! I keep missing these jumps. Okay, I need to remember, was the guru up here? I'm not sure what causes the guru to appear when he does appear either. Dude, there's stuff everywhere. Oh, this is where Guru is. Powerful clock. Alright, Raccoon, I think you were onto something earlier. The technique is to just always be bashing. ABB. Always be bashing. Okay, I need to learn how to jump without taking damage. Look at him go! His 3 frames of animation. Is that even 3? It's 2. He literally has 2 frames of animation. This is tremendous. That's all you need, really. These penguins. Dude! One thing that's really throwing me off is that Prehistoric Man here has a deceptively large hurt box. I'm gonna intentionally die here. Strategic death. To give me a full health bar when we pick up the spring. There we go.
Dude! Go! Can't wait for it.
This is just so charming. This is just pure fun. That was impossible. Okay. The placement of the spider and the fire means I don't think I can get through here without getting hit since I have the spring. The spring harms me there. Okay. Get out of here.
Guru!
I can't get up there in time. You can jump and attack. That wasn't worth it.
Oh, dude.
I think there might be a graphical glitch here. Kind of standing on nothing there. Get out of here, bear. Oh dear. Let's just go for it. So, what is with this part?
Dude!
Okay. Just gotta be careful. Level 5, still this way. Okay. Snowman! Okay, gotta be careful here. Spring hop over the bird. Gotta get up there.
Oh dear, dude!
Bash him. That's dangerous. I don't need those pieces. I definitely want to get that hammer. I'll try jumping over the spider. Didn't work. We're back at the beginning of the level. Dude, that's pretty mean. Alright, I see what you're doing here, game. I'm probably going to run out of time now before I can make it back to the end of the stage.
Get out of here!
Careful. Okay, well, I lost the spring and the hammer there. The greed got me killed. We have to rush to the end now. Bird. Let's go up.
You can't.
Go. All stairs. Go. Go. Ah, dang it. What is this? Go. Ugh. Okay, it's not the end of the stage, it looks like. It looks like we still have... Oh, it is the end of the stage. Okay. Whew. This game rules. Are we gonna get another full screen boss? Are we gonna get another full screen boss? Yeah, that was level 3. Why was the sign pointing to level 5? I guess eventually we'll end up at level 5. It's not wrong. Please wait. What? Oh, I died. We have to actually game. Okay, we gotta hit him right in the tail, and he kills you in one hit, and this might be impossible. Oh no! This might be impossible! Okay. Okay, this might be easy. Wonderful. I love the skeleton in the ring. I got utterly destroyed there, but now that I figured that out, that should be pretty consistent too. To just beat him up on future attempts. We're probably going to run out of lives again and have to restart, but I'm perfectly fine with that. I have no idea how many stages there are, and please no spoilers if anybody knows. I hate to get spoilers for Prehistorik. The box said there are over 150 screens, so whatever that means. Please wait. Ooh. I mean, this is a one-disc Amiga game. A one-disc Amiga game with unique artwork and music for every stage. And so there really can't be a whole heck of a lot just because of space constraints. Dude! Mushroom? This music's going really hard. Snake? Ah, dang it. Is that a radish? I'll take it. Oh, dude! Ah, the caveman nuts. Bash the bears. Got a fire breather here. Just gotta get up there. Is there another one? Nope. A can of R. I want it. Huh? Oh, this is highly mysterious here. Oh, dude, the squirrel is a nuisance. Kangaroo! We gotta jump to bash the bird. God, this is so good. I don't want to lose my spring, but I think I'm going to lose my spring. How many screens does it feel like each level's been? I don't know. It's hard to gauge that sort of thing. It feels like, I don't know, 15, 20 screens per stage so far. So if we're going for over 150, you could assume, I don't know, 7, 8 levels maybe? Just a guess. Are these death platforms? No. There goes my spring. Okay. Ah, dude, these things are so hard. It's... extra life. It's quite the challenge to try to avoid taking hits in this. You just get whittled down everywhere you go. Guru! Oh, the benevolent guru has bestowed an extra life upon us. I knew that was gonna happen. Dude! Go in! Up! Woohoo! Look at this vertical scrolling! What is this wizardry? Get him! Is that an exit up there, maybe? If I go up and left, perhaps? Mayhaps. It is. Ooh. Oh, we've ascended into the trees! Go! This is very scary here. Go. Go. No. Go. Guru, come to me, Guru. Okay, we gotta get the fire breather. I don't need any of this. Don't need. Dude, look at this platforming. Aw, this is the good stuff. Give me that carrot. That radish. Nom nom nom. What? Whoa! That was cool! Okay, please wait. Oh, Cheese Whiz, welcome. I love the grossly inflated screen number count. It's especially prevalent in like adventure games, text adventures specifically. Our game has 10,000 screens. It turns out there's 5 that you need to visit. It just takes you 35 hours to find those 5. It definitely feels pretty easy, J.D. Amato, for an Amiga game. Amiga games have a reputation of being impossibly difficult, and this is completely playable. Which is good for... I'm happy with that. I'm completely fine with a game that's not impossibly difficult. It is fun to actually progress smoothly into a video game and just bash enemies. Is this going to be another boss? Is there a boss between every single stage? This might be the best game ever made. Please wait. Oh, dude! What? Get him! What? What? The biggest of dudes. I don't even know what I'm supposed to be doing here. Get it right in the... This is the best game ever made. This is it. We've peaked. Nothing can ever top this. Ah, he got me. Okay. Dun, 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 dun. Oh, look at the musculature. Why is our prehistoric man the side only go up to his teeny little ankles? I have so many questions that I don't think I want to have the answers to. Let's just bash him. Tremendous. Marvelous. Absolutely wonderful. Please wait. Please wait while loading level 7. What if we finish this game in like an hour? I didn't have another game planned. I thought this would be like a 3-4 hour game. What if it's not? We might have to do an audible. We might have to improvise. I think we could improvise. Ooh!
Look at this, dude! This!
Go! It's astounding that every single stage has unique artwork and music. This is really loud. There's no way to pause. I'm gonna turn this down a little. It's a little bit better. That was really loud.
Who's this?
Let's go get those pots before we jump over to our little dino friend. Had to appreciate the art for a moment. Who's this? Another caveman to bash? Did I eat him? My food went up for killing that man. Oh, you gotta eat. I guess we jump in the pit. Oh, vertical scrolling. I'll take these. Red dinos. Oh. All right, we have to keep going down, I see. Oh god, oh god. Dun 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 dun. The thing instantly kills you. Okay. That was unfortunate.
Guru! Guru!
I missed him. Things like this are scary. I think we jump and then scroll the screen. If this is evil, if you just walk to the right, the platforms don't align, so you would die. You have to jump for the screen transition. That's pretty evil. I like it. Oh god, oh god. Get him! Ah! Skeletonized. Okay, well, we still have plenty of lives. We're in no danger. Full on food. What the heck? Dude. Okay. Just ignore. Oh god, oh god. Come here, guru. Ooh, a spring. Bum 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 bum. Okay, there goes the spring. Hitboxes in this game are just kind of... they're there, I assume. Somewhere, hidden. I don't need any of the food there. Jump! Oh, yes. Dun, 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 dun. Like, even here, the club is not coming into contact with any part of this enemy's sprite. Yet, we can still deal damage and bash him from here. Quite baffling. Jump. Oh, dude, they all just line up perfectly to get bashed. I can't get to the guru. Ooh, clock. I think we're back at the beginning of the stage. We're back at the beginning. Oga. Gotta hurry. Come back here. Dun 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 dun. Oh god! Okay, we're gonna come to the three doors, and the one on the left was the back orb. Here's the three. So let's go in the middle door this time. Okay, don't need any of that. Oh, this has got to be the end here. If only I had an axe. Just an unstoppable whirlwind of violence. Yes, dude! Get him! Please wait. Rat Clown Car, welcome. Space Hoppercopter, welcome. Ray, welcome. Inner Worlds. I don't know if I'm familiar with that one. Boss time again? Boss? 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 Another full screen boss? Oh! What? What? Okay, I guess this is our reward. This is wonderful. Ooga! What was the narrative journey here? Like, I don't understand. We went to the fiery caves of hell, into a elevator cave, and now we've found our tribe, our family. Are these just some random other people? Were we out hunting food for them? Were we gone for 4, 8, 12? Were we gone for 14 days? Look at the parrot. Look at the little baby. All right, let's press a button and see what happens. All right. Wonderful. Wonderful. There we have it. There's Prehistorik. Gifted with intelligence, he sets off in search of Nosh. Yeah, that was the story. The narrative journey was we were searching for Nosh. Cool. Thank you for the GGs. What a wonderful game. You know what? You know what I think? I think this game was so good. I think this game was so tremendous. I think the only thing we can do now is play it again. Let's just play it again. We're just gonna play it again immediately. Because that was so good. That was so much fun. I want to bash some stuff and get a higher score, and let's just play it again. Let's try and go for the no death playthrough. Yeah, the no death run. That was surprising. Like, the entire game, that last attempt was, what, 30 minutes, maybe? Surprisingly short, but again, this is a one-disc game. And Amiga discs can't hold too much data. And with the unique graphics and music for every single stage, it was bound to be relatively short. And a lot of times games would compensate for that by making their games incredibly difficult as well. This one, no. It's very civilized, very reasonable.
Dude!
Alright, the no death run is in jeopardy. I'm already taking chip damage from these fires. I missed the guru. Dude, I've almost taken a death already. Like, honestly, I almost prefer games to be short and sweet rather than too long for their own good. Not that it's a one or the other sort of thing. Obviously, there's middle ground. But I think it's better to err on the side of leaving the player wanting more rather than having just too much stuff in the game.
Yeah, I agree. Degenesisify.
Especially when it comes to, like, platformers. Because really, as much as I love platformers, there's not a lot of depth to the gameplay. So it's good to just dive in, have a fun time, and then get out of there, do something else.
Oh yeah, feel free to...
Spoilers, yeah. If you know something, some secret tips, please let me know. Fall in the first water pit. Aye aye, Captain.
Yo!
Alright, that's cool. That's true, Dino. Sometimes you're just in the mood for an RPG. And you know, I've been in the mood for an RPG lately. Last time I tried to get my RPG fix, I made a grave mistake. And tried playing Shadow Madness for the PlayStation. And that was not good. So I've been wanting to play another RPG. I think maybe next week. I'm thinking next week we might begin another... an RPG for sickos. I'll put it that way. We'll do a sicko RPG. Yeah, dude, Unlimited Saga too. I've kind of been striking out when it comes to RPGs lately. And we did play Questron between those two. The old Apple II game. That's an RPG as well, just very different style. Shadow Hearts looks so fun. I'd have to play Codelka first though. Not that that's a bad thing.
Oh, dude, the guru!
Oh, I see Bonobo, just you wait and see. We got bosses. I saw that prostitution, that Ultima Underworld translation. Might be worth checking out. I've never played an Ultima game. I've never played any Ultima games in my life. Dude, how do you do this? Dun, 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 bum, bum, bum. Go! Jump! Took the hit. Okay. Oh dear! Oh, dude, I'm getting owned. Okay. Oh, get out of here. This game is so fun. It's just... there's such a visceral satisfaction to just mashing the attack button and just bashing everything you come across. Oh, I died. There's the extra life. Perfect. Okay, now we can speed run to the end of the stage. Dude! It would be so hard to do this game without dying. Because you just constantly take damage from everything. Jumping to the left in the water from the platform on the next screen. So you mean this screen here? You want me to jump to the left? Oh... like from right here, jump left. Putting my trust in you, pile of junk mail. Barbarian to cyborg, welcome. Let's go! Oh. Up to jump, up also climbs ladders, so. Either I missed, or there's nothing there. Oh dear. Moving on. Dude. We're in danger. Oh my goodness. I gotta look for extra lives, no? I think the guru is here, yep. Come on, baby, give me life! I'll take the hammer. Hammer's good. Oh dear! Sloppy here. I should probably just run to the end. I have more than enough food. Nosh, rather. Alright, let's go. Please wait. Bosses don't do enough. Hard mode could add those things. Yeah. I don't know. I'm happy with this game the way it is. I think it's good to have games that are playable by humans. As opposed to a lot of Amiga games, which are completely insane. Please wait. Dude, the bosses in this are so cool. And just the rhythm, the pace of this game, it's stage boss, stage boss, stage boss, stage boss, stage boss, stage boss. It's so good. It's just rapid fire. Every stage has new graphics, new enemies, new music. Get him! Dead. Wings of Death. Yeah, I've never heard of that. I'm not a big shoot 'em up gamer. I have a very limited experience with shmups. I'm not very good at them. I think they can be they're pretty fun, but it takes a lot of practice to get good at them. I just haven't put in the time. Ultima console versions? It's not a bad idea, Rat Clown Car. What I'm thinking of when it comes to Ultima, I kind of want to play the Ruins of Virtue games. I think I might start with those. Because those games look like a lot of fun. Please wait. Alright, we're back up to 3 lives, because every time you finish a level, you get an extra life. So we got a life for finishing level 1, and then killing the boss gave me another life. Now we're up to 4 lives! Wait, what? Am I tripping out here? Did I just get an extra life for walking to the right? I think I did. I'll take it. Oh, Mortis, welcome. I'm aware of that game, Dino. Classic Kusoge. Legendary bad game. I don't think it has a complete translation is the problem. My understanding is there's no full translations into English. Otherwise, I would play it. Ooh, martini. Male, welcome. Oh, no! Okay. This game is so cool. This might be my new favorite game ever. To the music! Get that. Guru! Okay, I've got a hammer, but I'm one hit away from death. And I lost it. These penguins are a problem. Okay, let's go in the cave. So yeah, for those who missed it, I literally beat this game in like 1 hour and 10 minutes, and I liked it so much we're just playing it again. I thought this would be a lot longer and harder than it was, simply because it's an Amiga game. Typically when I think of Amiga games, I think of impossible difficulty, but nope. This has been a very reasonable, civilized game. Short and sweet. Oh, the bears. This is dangerous. Whoa. See, when I have the spring, it makes these a lot harder. We gotta go like over the spider. Oh, wait. Oh! 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 Okay, I know the secret now. The spiders don't have active hurt boxes when they're up. I'll burn. Okay, I got owned a little bit. That's fine. Check out these caves. Yeah, that's it, Cadus. It's completely nonsensical RPG for Famicom. With, like, the overworld has towns on it that are completely invisible. You literally have to just step on every single tile to find the towns. Whenever you leave a town, you you exit back onto the overworld at the very start of the game. Even if you're, like, at the end of the game and you leave a town, it just takes you back to the start. It's, like, wildly random enemies. You can fight the hardest enemies in the game right off the bat. It's completely broken, legendarily bad. I kind of want to play it. I just took damage. These fish are hard to avoid. Oh, wonderful. The snowman? Aren't there only like two of these snowmen in the game? There's one less now. This is the backwards warp. We don't want to grab that. I wonder how long it would take to do a speedrun of this game. Like, if you actually routed out all the food pickups and everything. I feel like it's one of those games that might be like half just loading. Because these stages aren't that long. Guru! I can't get to him! Ah, that was close, but not quite good enough. Alright, okay. I guess I missed the jump. The blast, welcome. I definitely want to play Prehistorik 2. I just don't have it ready for today. I like to set up games in advance. And I didn't think I'd finish this game and enjoy it quite so much and just be ready to play the second one right away. If I would have known. Not enough food. I can't see my food meter. Okay, maybe that walrus will give me just enough. Oh dear, we could be in dire straits here. I'm one pixel away. One pixel. Absolute disaster. I skipped too many caves. Oh, dude! Okay. Now we have enough food. Let's go back. Let's try and make it back without dying. Time is really tight. We only have 7 unit. Okay. Scratch that idea. So next is the rhinoceros boss fight. If I don't get a handle on him really quickly, he could annihilate me. Mm-hmm. It's pretty easy, though.
Oh, Jazz Jackrabbit.
I've played the first Jazz Jackrabbit. I don't know if I ever played all the episodes. It's been a very long time. I have played, and I'm well familiar with Mr. Jackrabbit. Please wait.
Oh, Cody, you welcome. Nice, Prehistorik 2.
Dude, this game is tremendous. I can't wait to play the sequel. I can't wait. Maybe we'll just play it tomorrow. Maybe. Maybe we'll just play it tomorrow. Okay, Rhino. So you want to wait here. Once he turns around, you just go... There we go. he's dead. Wonderful.
Dude, the little skeleton, all the eyes, like, who's watching?
I guess the other cavemen. Please wait. So what was level 5? Level 5 is now the trees and the jungle, and then we go to the caves of hell. Powerful French cavemen watching the showdown between prehistoric man and rhino. I guess I could do like fast forward or something, but we'll just sit here and wait. It asks us nicely to wait, so let's just wait.
Little roly-poly snake demons. Got him. Get owned, bear.
Bash the mushrooms.
Yeah, there's probably secret rooms you can find, like maybe one on every stage or something silly like that.
But if they all consist of like jumping into what would appear to be death pits, it's very hard to find them. Because you don't actually get a whole heck of a lot of lives in this game. Alex, where are we? We gotta go in the cave. Oh dear.
Yeah, you get a free 1-up every stage. The manual tells you about that. Every stage you complete gets you an extra life.
And you can also find them. Apparently they're hidden everywhere throughout the stages, and I just never find them.
Oh, is it every 10,000?
Oh, you got a good eye. I haven't been watching. Flashbang. That might be why I just mysteriously got a 1-up earlier. I could explain it. Right, we're almost to 50,000. We'll track the score here. Yep, extra life. Would you look at that? Okay, this is a perfectly civilized, reasonable video game.
Oh dear.
There goes that life. Okay, there's another life here.
Guru.
Ooh, the axe. The axe is so good. I guess if you're going for a speed run, you just, what, reset until you get an axe right away? And then just never die? Too bad. Well, you lose it between stages. So I guess it's probably not that important, but it does, would help things a lot. Up in the trees now. Like, there's probably something to the left here. No? No? Okay. Just death. A pixel perfect jump for nothing. Cool. I approve. Well played. Dude, I can't get over how good the music is, too. This is just like the immaculate video game. Look at this, little ice cream cones.
Oh, guru!
I missed him. Okay, we have enough food, so I don't need to pick those up anymore. The squirrels are a problem, but they're not too hard to avoid. They are a bit of a problem. There's a couple blind jumps in this, but it's never, like, too hard to reason out where you're meant to go. Like, the blind jumps don't bother me.
Oh, dude, I just got owned! Okay.
Bird!
Than this part?
Whee! Time for the best boss ever. The best boss ever. The coolest, the best. Just have to wait for a couple minutes here. So I assume the score rolled over to 60,000, so I probably got an extra life for that, plus an extra life for clearing the stage. So we might end up with, what, 6 lives now? Maybe 5? I don't know. I wasn't paying enough attention to see what I was at when I exited the stage. Please wait. There's also a... I guess, theoretically, there's a maximum score you could get in this game. Since enemies don't respawn. That'd be tough. That'd be tough to go for like a high score run, since you get the timer bonus at the end of the stage, but you have to collect everything along the way as well.
Here he is! Yo, Soda Magoda, Tango Bunny, welcome!
Tango, I beat the game already. I'm replaying it because this is tremendous. Look at this! This is the best. Oh, he got me. He's good. Dun, 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 dun. Careful, careful, careful. Dun, 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 dun. He's dead. I want to play as that guy. I guess I'd have to play Zedette if I want to play as this guy. I guess my one complaint, and it's very minor, it doesn't affect my enjoyment of the game whatsoever. My one complaint is that the game doesn't end on a boss fight. It feels kind of weird to end the game on a stage rather than a boss fight. Like, they should have moved that fight to after this stage here, I think. It's still a wonderful game, don't get me wrong, but it just feels a little jarring to go from a stage, boss, stage, boss, stage, boss, rhythm, and then it just ends after a stage. And here we are, the last level.
Get ready, the caves of hell.
Go!
Oh, Guru!
Maguru is really hard to find and to get. You have to know exactly where they're gonna be ahead of time. So I guess is incentive for replayability. Amstrad version compares to this. It can't have the hot jams, so it's probably just inferior in that aspect. It might still be pretty cool to check out, though.
Oh, the rival tribe! Let's bash him. Bash him and feast on his flesh.
Fireball. Okay, we got the hammer, but I don't have a lot of life to make use of the hammer, so let's just not get hit from here on out. Into the pit. the tin cans of rations of R. There's two of them. That's not the backwards warp. We're safe to take this one. It was a backwards warp, but not very far. Okay. Thank you for nothing. You disappointed me. There goes the hammer. Be aggressive. Full on food. 5 lives. We're almost at the end of the stage. Guru meditation. Ooh, 6. Whoops. Oga, Oga. Just run. Oh, the stackage. Guru! I can't get to him. There's no way.
Beat it again.
Prehistorik. What a wonderful game. Almost got 100,000 points. So that was a decent score. I think we can get 100,000. I think it's possible. It's all about that life bonus. Not dying and accumulating multiple lives will just cause a snowball effect on your score. And the timer bonus isn't that much in comparison. Alright, let's watch the ending again. Wonderful. A baby with grotesquely large toes and feet. A bodacious caveman babe, a scrawny caveman man, a hunchback parrot, and a rippling protagonist, muscularity of the back, cave teen, yes. Da, 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 da. What a good game. What a delightful game. What a tremendous, wonderful game. Yeah, it's short, but it's sweet. It's jam-packed with unique graphics, music, boss fights, fun platforming, satisfying combat where you just mash the button and bash literally everything. it's exceptional game. Exceptional game. Incredible. 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 That's it. Well, thanks for watching. Prehistorik. That's all I had lined up for today. I think we'll just call it there. A nice short and sweet stream. 2.5 hours. They don't all need to be epic 6, 7, 8 hour marathons. I think we'll wrap it up there. Thank you all for watching. That was so much fun. That was so much fun. That was like a rejuvenating, enjoyable experience. Oh, it's so nice to have a just pure fun game after playing Bart's Nightmare and Virtual Bart and those other games. We could continue Bart's Nightmare. We're not going to, though. Well, thanks for watching, everybody. Thanks for hanging out. I had a great time playing this. We'll wrap it up there, but I'm planning on coming back tomorrow for more game. I definitely want to play Prehistorik 2. We might just dive straight into Prehistorik 2 tomorrow. Maybe we'll play another caveman game. Maybe we'll play something radically different. Maybe we'll play a NES game. Maybe we'll play a Spectrum game. Maybe we'll play another Amiga game. Maybe we'll play another Simpsons game. It could be anything. It could be anything. I don't even know what it's going to be yet. I'll be back tomorrow for more game. Thanks for watching, everybody. Let me find somebody to raid. Let's get out of here. I've done my thing. I've said my piece. I've had a good time. I can game no more. Till tomorrow, at least. Who's on? Freaking everybody's on. Oh! Perfect. Perfect. We're going to raid Lord Jiggy. We're going to raid Lord Jiggy. Jiggy's a wonderful streamer. Exceptionally powerful. He's playing a wonderful indie barbarian game called Beholgar. It looks like a lot of fun. I really want to play it myself. Jiggy's really fun to watch. I like watching his streams. Unfortunately, we kind of conflict with time slots, so I don't get to watch him as often as I'd like. Take care, everybody. Thanks for watching. Adios. I'll catch y'all next time. Farewell. Bye-bye. See ya.